So today, we shall take up one of the most salient features of the coherent topology, which allows us to practical way of constructing continuous functions. As a consequence, we shall prove the existence of partition affinity on CW complexes. This will essentially prove that they are paracompact, because if you have a Hausdorff space, then paracompactness is equivalent to existence of partition affinity. Of course, the theme of constructing the functions by step by step, namely skeleton by skeleton, will occur again and again in other contexts also. The only thing that we assume is that you are familiar with partition affinity, especially if the space is compact and Hausdorff, then you must be knowing how to construct partition affinity. Nevertheless, whatever is required here, I will recall all the definitions and so on. You start with a topological space. A partition affinity on X, we mean family of continuous functions. That continuity is important here. Some family indexed by some set lambda, say. So these functions theta, they are all defined on the whole of X, taking values in the closed interval 0, 1. They will satisfy one of those two conditions. For each X, you can find a neighborhood of X in X, such that that neighborhood will intersect only finitely many supports of theta alpha, which is same thing as saying that only for finitely many alpha, theta alphas will be non-zero on an X. This is called local finiteness of the family theta alpha. The second condition makes it possible. The first condition makes it possible to put the second condition. Second condition says that the sum of all theta alpha at any given point is equal to 1. And that should be true for all X inside X. In any given X, summation of all theta alpha must be equal to 1. The sum makes sense because of condition 1. Essentially, because though the family may be infinite, the sum will be finite at every point. Okay, so that is the definition of partition affinity. But now it has to do with many relations with other things, namely starting with a covering, open covering of X. A family theta alpha is said to be subordinate to you, the covering. If you have a function on the indexing sets, see lambda is the indexing set of theta and I is the indexing set for the covering. Okay, so function should be from lambda to I, such that support of theta alpha, where alpha is inside lambda, which is by definition closure of all the points wherein theta alpha of X is not equal to 0. That is a subspace of closed subset of X. That must be contained inside U of something, and that something is beta alpha. So that beta is the function. That function beta is called refinement function. So each support is contained inside some open subset of this cover, corresponding to this cover. It's a standard result over any Euclidean space, any subspace of Euclidean space. There is always a partition affinity subordinate to any given cover. This is much easier to prove than proving such a thing on a paracompact spaces, whatever they are. Similar to our earlier lemma 1.2 of extending neighborhoods and functions, the key result that we need is to if the following was relative version of union partition of unity, so that functions can be patched up using the patching up process in a CW complex. So what we need is a relative version, which means if you have some partition of unity on a part of a space, there must be something extending that to the whole space. So that is what I'm going to define here. And these are temporary definitions. You may not find them in literature elsewhere. So start with a family. Now I am writing eta alpha here. A family of real world functions on x. An open cover w of x is said to ensure local finiteness. So we want to bring that local finiteness condition more active here. Okay, condition one, more explicit. So it is supposed to ensure local finiteness of theta if for each w in w, the set of all alpha in lambda such that w intersection support of eta alpha is not equal to empty set, this is finite. See, local finiteness ensures that there is some such cover. So if w is such a cover, open cover, then you say that w ensures the finiteness for theta. Okay, so that is just the reference. So this is followed by point one there. And so I am making this definition here so that we can keep talking about what is the cover which will ensure the finiteness. Second definition is take Y containing third X, a subspace. Now you have an open cover for X and a partition of unity on Y subordinate to the restricted cover. The restricted cover is defined by taking any member of U and intersecting it with Y. So collect all of them, that will be obviously a cover for Y. And it's an open cover for Y. So for with that cover should be subordinate, should be the dominant, namely the partition of unity must be subordinate to that. Okay. And correspondingly, let beta be the refinement function. And let W be an open cover for Y, which ensures local finiteness. So all these things play important role in the definition of extension. Now, let us have theta hat. Okay, this is the definition. Theta hat, a collection of psi alpha, where alphas are inside another indexing set lambda prime. Okay, suppose this is a partition of unity subordinate to U, such that what? These are the conditions. So it's going to be quite lengthy definition. First of all, indexing set here, the new indexing set must be the larger than the original index set. Okay, this containment, maybe equality also is allowed. That's not a problem. For each alpha in lambda, for the old members, this psi alpha restricted to Y must be eta alpha. So that is the meaning of psi alpha for extensions. Okay, psi alpha restricted to Y is eta alpha. And for each W inside W, the ensuring local finiteness, there is an open subset VW of X. So the extensions of now, these open covers themselves, you see VW of X, such that VW intersection Y is W. So each W is extended to an open subset of X now. And what is the property of this extension? The extension set of all the FW I have defined, set of all alpha belong to lambda prime, which is support of psi alpha intersection VW is non-empty. Okay. So this was, remember, this FW was all alpha belonging to lambda, such as support of psi alpha intersection, W was non-empty. Now I want this FW equal to this larger set. Look at all psi alpha, which may intersect VW, the extended thing. okay, no new member should come there. That is the meaning of this. FW is equal to this one. FW is already inside this one, but I want FW is equal to this right hand side. Okay, which just means that you are adding extra members here in the indexing set. Those functions, okay, support of those functions should not enter the open subset coming from W at all, old Ws. They should be away from them. You should not enter even an extensions of those. So small extensions must be there. So this is a very strong condition. Okay, you have to understand this one carefully. Okay. The fourth condition is, there is a refinement function beta prime from lambda prime to I for theta hat, and this beta prime must be an extension of beta. That means for old member lambda elements inside lambda, beta prime must be beta itself. So with all these, the indexing set, indexing function, the refinement function is extended, indexing set is extended, functions are extended. Okay, and the third condition is that the new functions are somewhat away from the old functions. That is something important here. Okay, we then call psi alpha an extension of theta alpha. Alpha belongs to lambda. This is a technical definition, so that instead of repeating all these four conditions, I just say this is an extension of theta alpha. Okay. Thus, an extended partition of unity consists of extensions of all old functions to the larger space, together with some extra functions to cover up the rest of the larger space. It is important that we make the technical assumption that the support of these extra functions do not enter into a neighborhood of the smaller space. This is ensured by extending the cover, which ensures the local finiteness. Finally, we shall also need to extend the refinement function. So extra caution is needed when we want to build up the partition of unity in the inductive process. Okay, all these four points here are important to keep in mind. So here is an elaborate proposition which will ensure the step-by-step extensions. Let X be obtained from Y by attaching K cells. Okay, so you can put an indexing set for these K cells also, J in J. Let U be an open covering for X, theta be a partition of unity indexed by lambda on Y. Okay, and subordinate to this restricted covering. Then there is a partition of unity theta hat, which I am indexing by lambda prime on X, which is an extension of beta alpha, and is subordinate to the cover U. Okay, the statement is over here, but we want to say, what is happening to all these local covering, which ensures local finiteness also. Okay. So moreover, given open neighborhoods, y belong to y, such that this wi, y in y of y, this is an open cover, ensures local finiteness of theta. You start with this also hypothesis here. You start with, instead of just eta alpha and this one, you fix this also. Then there are open neighborhoods W x hat of x, such that the open cover W x hats of x ensure the local finiteness for theta hat. But these W x hats are nothing but W, whenever this x is inside y, w x hat, which is w y hat, intersection y is w y. This is for points inside y. So even this will happen. Okay, so while extending, we can keep track of that this also happens. This is the statement of the proposition. Okay, now why you need such a thing? That is more curious to you than the proof of this one, I would ensure, sir. Therefore, let me go to the proof of the partition affinity using this one first. Demonstrate that, then you will know the role of these extra assumptions and so on, so that later on you can figure out how to prove that. Okay, so assuming this proposition, let us first prove the main theorem. Okay, so what is the main theorem? Main theorem is, start with any open covering of a CW complex X. Okay, then there is a partition of unity on X which is subordinate to U. The final theorems are always neatly stated as briefly as possible. Okay, with all the hypotheses included. That should be a style of the final theorem, so that it is quotable without all the paraphernalia of the notations that you might have introduced in the proof. Okay, so take an open covering for a CW complex. There is always a partition affinity subordinate to that open cover. That is the statement. Now, how do we begin? We start with the zero cells, the zero skeleton. What is a zero skeleton? It's a discrete set. Okay. That discrete set itself will be used as the indexing set for the partition affinity now. Okay. So, put lambda naught is going to be an indexing set equal to x naught, namely the set of all the vertices of x naught, the zero skeleton. And define these functions have now indexing. The first zero corresponds to the zero level, x corresponds to the indexing level, the indexing set from x zero to I by the formula p zero x of y is equal to 1 if y is x. That means these are indicator functions. They are delta functions. If x equal to y, it is 1, otherwise it is 0. So at each point, you take the function identically 1 at that point and 0 elsewhere. So that is the first stage construction. Obviously, when you take the sum of all this, what happens? You get only at any point, you get only that function, and that function is 1. Everywhere else it's 0. So sum total will be, all other things are 0. Sum total is also 1. So it's automatically a partition affinity. And since x naught is discrete, each point is an open subset here. So it is a closest also. So support is contained inside there itself, right? So each x naught, by the way, is contained inside some member of U. Because U is a covering for the whole of X. So it will be subordinate to U also. So we shall fix up even the subordinated function here. Since X naught is discrete, this is clearly a partition of unity on X naught. Put W naught equal to singleton X, X naught belong to X. So that will ensure local finiteness, because there is the only P zero X will be non-zero here. All other things will be zero. So clearly W naught is an open cover, which ensures local finiteness of P0x. So it's an open cover for x naught. Okay. So it's actually all the singleton zeros I have taken, singleton points I have taken. So let beta naught, this is the refinement function, lambda naught to I be a refinement function. I have to choose for each point x belonging to x naught some member of U, and if that is I can write it as beta naught of that. Beta naught of that x goes to that point. that I, whatever. You can choose any, so you have freedom here. Okay? Inductively. Now, immediately we put the induction step and the previous proposition comes into picture. So what is the inductive step is precisely we have defined correctly here. Okay. Each xn is obtained by attaching n plus 1 cells to xn minus, n cells to xn minus 1, right? Applying the previous proposition, we get a sequence. To begin, we have constructed already lambda naught. So that will get extended to lambda 1. So now we have partition of unity on lambda 1. That will extend to lambda 2 and so on. So you get a tower of what? Indexing sets. They may be all equal, I don't care. But one is contained in the other is all that I need. So you have get a sequence of indexing sets. That is the first thing. For each n, n is fixed at xn, a partition of unity, which I will denote by pn. But it's indexed by the indexing set lambda n now. So pn alpha, double indexing. Okay. Alpha ring of x, lambda n is fixed here. And these are partition of unity on xn, this nth skeleton, which is an extension of pn minus 1, n minus 1 stage thing, pn minus 1 half alphas. Of course, these alphas will range over lambda n minus 1. Okay, it's an extension of that, as we have seen. Namely, whenever you take an alpha inside lambda n minus 1, restricted to pn alpha, take pn alpha restricted to xn minus 1, it must be equal to pn minus 1 of alpha. That's it. For each n, a family wn which ensures local finiteness for wn, we shall index wnx, x belong to xn, of neighborhoods of x in xn, which ensure local finiteness for pn alpha. Such that whenever x is in the lower skeleton, we must have wnx intersection xn minus 1 equal to wn minus 1 of x. Okay? So this was the part of the proposition. So we have all these things here. Okay? The fourth condition is for each n, the refinement function is also an extension of it. So I'm just repeating the thing that is ensured by the previous proposition here. Okay, now what we do? We put lambda equal to union of all these lambda n's. It's increasing union of indexing sets. For each alpha inside lambda, I can choose a k such that alpha first time appears in lambda k. That means it is not in lambda k minus 1 or the previous ones. The first time it appears in lambda k. Okay, and that k is unique. Define p alpha, okay, from x to, for each alpha I have defined function, right, x to I now, by the property that p alpha restricted to any nth skeleton is pn alpha restricted to n. If I knew that these restrictions, okay, are continuous, first of all. Secondly, that they agree. See, when you restrict this one, suppose you take xn plus 1. Xn plus 1, the function restricted to xn must be the old function. Then only it makes sense. And that is what is guaranteed by this condition. Okay, that they are extensions. Right? Condition 1 says they are extensions of the old thing. Right? So once alpha is inside K, right? So that is the first time some Pn alpha will appear there. After that, it's getting extended only. So this makes sense. From property 2, it follows that each P alpha is well defined and continuous on X. Okay, that is property. Continuity follows because of what? The fundamental property of the Coindis topology on the CW complexes. Okay, we claim that this theta alpha is the required partition affinity subordinate to U. That will complete the proof. Okay, and subordinate to U means I have to define a function beta, which is a refinement function. Take beta from lambda to I to be such that beta restricted to lambda n is beta n for all n. Remember, if I restrict to beta lambda n minus 1, it is beta n minus 1, because beta n restrict to lambda n minus 1 also beta n minus 1. So this makes sense for all n. Okay, so this makes sense, and beta is well defined. Suppose now alpha is in lambda. Choose an n such that alpha is in the first lambda n. So like here, okay. So alpha is in lambda n, but not in lambda n minus 1. Then for all m bigger than n, what we have? Support of p alpha intersection with xm, which is the largest skeleton, which is same thing as support of pm alpha. Once you restrict it to it, same thing as pm alpha. By the very definition here, okay, p alpha restrict to xm will be pm alpha, okay, support of pm alpha, and that is contained inside u beta m of alpha by the very definition of beta m. But beta m on alpha is beta alpha because alpha is in xm. Once alpha is in lambda n, it is also in lambda m bigger than equal to n. So it's u beta. Therefore, support of this one successively is contained in u beta. So support of p alpha itself will be contained inside u of beta. So that's just beta alpha. Therefore, beta is a definite function for theta, and hence theta is subordinate to u. So here I am assuming that once this is there, the support of this, you know, it doesn't go on keeping going and increasing. It is equal to this one. So this is very important. Okay. So xm is larger, it doesn't have. Once m bigger than n, this will be always the support. Support pm alpha. And that we are keeping extending. The same alpha will be there for all of them. Therefore, beta is refinement function for the entire of theta subordinate, so which gives you subordinate into view. Now for any x in x, say again x is in xk minus xk minus 1, that such a k is unique. Okay, here we define wx to be union n greater than or equal to k all wn of x. Okay, starting with x inside k, you get first wk. That is the first time you get. Then you take wnx and so on, k plus 1x, k plus 2x, k plus 3x, and put union of all of them. Okay, they are successive extensions of the previous ones. It follows that if you take this wx x in x, this is an open cover for x. Why is an open set? Intersect with any n, it will be wnx. And wnx is open inside xn. All right. Of course, below x, below k, it's empty. So the empty is fine. So this is an open cover for x. Okay. Now we claim that this ensures local finiteness for theta. Okay. After that, taking the sum, it's equal to 1. That part is very easy. So let us see how local finiteness comes. For f of wx is by definition this one, okay, this will be union of all the f of wnx n greater than or equal to k, because these are indexing sets at points here, they will have to be in one of the indexing sets on this side and conversely. So it's union of all these, n greater than or equal to k is the starting point, k is the starting point, so it's n greater than or equal to k it will be. Okay, note f of wxk for each of them is finite by our inductive step. Okay, and for each n bigger than equal to k, what happens? F of w n x is equal to f of w n plus n x. And this is the condition that we have ensured here. Left hand side here, where was that? This point. This condition appears there. Okay. So new entries from n plus 1, n plus 2, etc., lambda n plus 2, etc., they don't come inside. That's why. So this is equal to w f of x n plus 1. For this one, and this is the same thing as this one. Successively keep going on like this. Therefore, f of w x is equal to f of w x k. Only the k thing with all other things are same as this one. It's so, though it's an infinite union, the same set, the beginning set is f of w k. So it's finite. Okay, that's the meaning of that, that this cover ensures the local finiteness. Finally, now again, x is inside xk minus 1 as before. After all, every x is inside some xk. K may be different, but there is a unique k like this. Summation p alpha over alpha is summation p of alpha. Alpha is only in lambda. K I can take. Beyond those things, whatever new things come, say for a lambda k plus 1, you know that the new functions are not are actually zero on xk. Okay, they are not entering. So this summation is only p alphas, where alpha is inside lambda k. I don't have to take a full lambda at all. But then this is the same thing as pk of alpha, because x is inside xk. So each p alpha is pk of alpha. Okay, the sum total is equal to 1 because this is a partition of unity on xk. So that completes the theorem. So next time, we will take care of this proposition. Again, this proposition will be proved in two steps. Okay, thank you.